All right, guys, it is the wee hours of the morning here in Western Australia, and we woke up early because we are trying to find one of the world's smallest marsupials, the honey possum. These tiny creatures only live in Western Australia and are rarely ever seen because they are super quick, hopping and bouncing from tree to tree. Now, while they are smaller than a mouse, they are actually related to koalas, kangaroos, and wombats. And if I'm able to catch one, I'm going to show you why this is one of the most impressive and smallest mammals in the entire world. Now, these creatures are very agile. In order to have any chance of getting one up close to the cameras, we're going to need to use some technology to aid us. So what we have here is a thermal scope. You can see the scanner here, a live feed on the phone, and it will detect any body heat coming off of these small possums. And if we are able to spot one on the scope, we're then gonna race out of the car and try to get hands-on with this super cool and super tiny marsupial. Joining us on our possum search is Max Jackson from Australia Wildlife Encounters. If there's anyone who can spot a creature in the outback, it's him. All right, so we're gonna start our search by looking for plants that flower because these honey possums live on a diet completely made up of flower nectar. So if we find flowers, that's going to be a good indication that there'll be honey possums in the area. This heathland habitat is perfect because typically at all times during the year, there's always going to be something in bloom. It didn't take long for Max to guide us to a location full of orange banksia flowers, a favorite of the honey possum. Unfortunately, by the time we got there, the day's temperatures rose and the thermal cameras became less and less effective, making it difficult to spot the tiny warm-blooded possums apart from the hot banksia trees. So we decided that although we found our location, we would need to return back the next morning for another try.
That's something.
That, it's on a flower too.
That's a possum.
That's a possum. Look at it, that's totally a possum.
We got it. You can see the thermal scope is picking up a small creature at the top of this flower. Hopefully that is the honey possum we were after. This is awesome. All right, let's go. Oh yeah, I see it.
Yeah, I see it. Yeah, I see him. I definitely see him, man. He's flying around there.
Yeah. All right, do you want me to hold, stand back, and you see if you can go for a grab?
Yeah.
I'll keep an eye on it with this laser.
Coming down at me.
Yeah, I don't see anything.
Thought I saw a flash of it when we first walked up, but it's hard to tell. I could have just been a branch in the wind.
So I saw him moving down. I kind of lost track of him from there. Hang on, there. That's him. He's moving around. He's at the bottom. He's like, he's this head level. He's around there somewhere.
Okay.
So he's gonna be at the top of this tree. Oh, I got him. I see him. I think he jumped down. Saw him for like a fleeting glimpse. All right. Well, let's keep trying. Yeah, he's like right there. Oh, I see him. I see him. I got eyes on him. Here, take the phone.
Yeah, okay, just drop it. It's fine.
Okay. I am looking at it. I am staring right at it. Oh, I just jumped. Yep. Got him. Where is he now? Oh, I see him. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, I'm so close. Oh my gosh. I can't believe I missed that. All right.
These guys move fast.
They are so incredibly quick. Is it the flower again? There's just too many escape routes for these honey possums to go. I can see them. I get within like an arm's reach, and then they see me and go bing and just jump to the other branch. And these trees are super dense. Like the leaves are very prickly. The branches are very stiff. So like moving the tree around is really complicated.
I almost had him.
I'm not joking. We may want to go back and get my tide pool net. because they are so fast.
We've got one. Oh, I see two. There's one up high. That one should be, that one looks like it's really resting easily. Let's go for it. All right, I'm gonna go in for a catch.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep. Here we go.
It's gonna be right here.
Yeah. There somewhere, right in front of it.
Should be looking right at it.
Hasn't moved yet.
Oh, I see him. He's up. Oh, wait. There's a little bird's nest there.
Ah.
But I think it was one of them because I saw a tail.
He's still
there. Oh, wait, I'm looking right at him.
Yep.
I see him. Okay. Looking right at him.
Oh, he's moving. He's running overhead.
Huh? I heard it. This way?
He's up high, actually. He's on a flower. You should be able to see him. He's there. In the back of that.
Got
him. Yeah.
Got one. Oh, we got a honey possum, guys. That was awesome. That was awesome. Hi. Oh my goodness. You are the cutest thing I have ever seen. Okay, the sun is coming up. Let's let the light expose the habitat a little bit better, and then we are gonna show you this tiny little creature up close and personal.
Wow, I am so excited to finally get hands-on with the honey possum. But before we learn more about it, let me take a moment to tell you about this video's sponsor while you take your first looks at that micro mammal. Let's face it, at times things can get overwhelming, but the pace of life, it's speeding up, which means more multitasking and more challenges. Take it from me, traveling the world to make YouTube videos can cross a lot of wires, but talking it through with someone I trust always makes me feel better. But now with today's sponsor, BetterHelp, you don't need to deal with everything on your own because they made it easier to access a therapist when life gets busy. BetterHelp connects you with a licensed therapist who's trained to listen and give you helpful, unbiased advice. And usually you'll get paired with a therapist within 48 hours so you can get started fast. So let BetterHelp connect you with a therapist that can help you all from the comfort of your own home. You can talk via phone call, video chat, or messaging, whichever way is most comfortable. Visit betterhelp.com/bravewilderness or use Brave Wilderness at sign up and enjoy a special discount on your first month. All right, now let's go meet that honey possum.
Oh, guys, look at how small this marsupial is. And yes, I know at first glance, it looks a little bit like a mouse, but in fact, this is a marsupial, namely because of how it rears its young. That when they, hey buddy, it's okay. It's a little nervous, I'm gonna talk a little quieter. So this little honey possum can give birth to 2 to 3 joeys at a time. And when they are born, they are no bigger than a grain of rice, making them the smallest mammal at birth in the world. And then they'll be reared in their mother's pouch for up to 3 months before they venture off to find their own flowers. These little honey possums can drink up to 7 milliliters of nectar in a day. That's the equivalent of a human being drinking 50 liters of soda. Could you imagine? So their metabolism is super fast. They are pretty much always hopped up on a good diet of sugar. Hi. Look at that iconic snout, which is developed to help them get at the plant nectar, the flowers in these Banksia trees. They are perfectly adapted for their food source. In addition to their slender snout, they also have a very long tongue, which is up to 1/4 length of their entire head. This tongue is covered in, hold on, I gotta get a better grip. Sorry, guys. We're almost done. We're gonna put you back on your flower, don't worry. Okay. Let's see if we can feed our friend here some sugar water. All right, ready? Oh yeah, look at that. Somebody was thirsty. You can see how it uses that little tongue to lap up the nectar. Yum, 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 yum. Oh my gosh, look how long his tongue is. Now their tongue is covered in bristles that helps it extract the nectar out of the flowers. And just like the bees behind us on the flower, these honey possums are extraordinary pollinators. Without them, this environment would certainly be in peril. They are a very important part of the ecosystem here in Western Australia, and they are also super cool.
Like many other marsupials, it is prehensile. Do you see how it grips onto my finger there, how it curls up? That prehensile tail can wrap around branches and allows this tiny little marsupial to grip onto flowers and tree limbs with great efficiency, and they can actually hang and support their entire body weight just with their tail. So me gently holding it here is totally fine for this creature. Their base of their tail is very strong and can support their entire body. Now, in addition to its prehensile tail, it also has a very interesting hind foot. Similar to a koala bear, it actually has a thumb that hangs out off the foot, four fingers, that allows it to really grab onto stems and limbs so it can get up on those flowers. So another distinguishing feature about the honey possum are those tiny little ears, which are quite large for its head. It has an extraordinary sense of hearing, and that's going to help it stay away from predators that would be out here trying to get them as they're feasting on flowers. Anything from a snake to a bird would make a meal out of a honey possum. They do have striping running along their back. The males have a bit more of a prominent stripe down the back, which leads me to believe that this is a male. Sir, thank you for joining us today on Brave Wilderness. Ow, he's trying to nip me a little bit. Luckily, the honey possum really lacks any serious teeth. It has a couple of flat, peg-like teeth, but nothing that's gonna give me a serious nip this morning. You are teeny tiny and super adorable. All right, now these creatures are nocturnal. The sun's starting to come up. I think it's time to put our honey possum back on its flower and let it nap for the rest of the afternoon. You were so good. Thanks for hanging out with us. How about a flower? Want a flower? You hungry? So cool. Oh, coming back? Back to me? Back to me? Oh, oh, oh. You gonna go back? Where are you going? Can I offer you a flower? All right, let's put the honey possum back in the bush. Oh, that's it. That's all she wrote. Honey possum scene, cut.